Hi guys, so welcome back to my channel. Thank you all for subscribing, for liking, for the comments. I'm seeing them all, so I really do appreciate that. So to the question of today, now you are an international student and you're a mature student. You've graduated from school for the past 10 years, 20 years, and now you're suddenly back to the schooling environment, you're back to the educational system, except that it's totally different from what you are used to. It is totally different from what you've experienced before. How do you intend to do it? That's a very big question, right? So some of us just forget that part. I'm like, oh, so we are now here in the UK, so yeah, we're going to do our masters and all of that. But by the time the classes begin, the shock, you know, the type of opening your book again, reading again, and all of that. We're already used to this hustler like type of life. We just wake up in the morning by 4 a.m., go to the office, then by 8, 6, 5, you're back home, and the circle goes on and on. So we are actually not used to the educational system anymore, whether it's in Nigeria or your own country or here in the UK. So this video is going to be giving you little tips on how to get back on your feet as a student. Some of us have already forgotten some of the reading techniques that we adopted years back that we were able to get back with our first class, our 2-1, our 2-2, and stuff like that, our distinction and all of that. So I'm just going to try to recap. I'm just going to try to walk you through steps you can actually adapt right now in order to make your master's program or you're going back into the school environment a very, very easy inflow step. Okay, so you get my point. So now, first of all, when you want to read, and I know we are used to this cramming system in Nigeria, yeah, but this place, they really actually want you to read to understand. So personally, what I recommend for you, since you've left books so long ago, I would say when you open your books, try to get used to the modules, try to get used to the topics and all of that. Just skim through the textbook. Except that the moment you are skimming through, you just have a jotter and a pen, and you write out the definitions you see, you write out the explanations you see, the steps, and so many of that, just to write it out on your jotter or on your jotting notes or your exercise book. So that's what you did, the first step. The second step right now is to actually read what you jotted down in that your notes, in that notes you were writing when you're reading your textbook, those things you deduced, you brought out, read through it. The third step is to retreat again. You're going to retreat twice. The third step is to retreat again. And then the fourth step is to try to ask your questions on it. Like, oh, for instance, say you read or you wrote out on your own jotting notes, you wrote, Simbi is a boy. Now you ask yourself the question, like, who is a boy? You should be able to answer that it is Simbi. The moment you're able to answer that question, it means you've actually read to understand. Yeah, cramming can come once in a while, but I only recommend cramming when it's on the exam day or there are some definitions or some words or some formulas that are really not sticking into your brain for whatever reason it is. So I think you should just cram it and just get do it. Yeah, but I don't think they really do write exams here. It's more of teamwork and all of that, group work, teamwork and all of that. So another step is this. To get back your student spirit, your student vibe, is to actually make sure you are very involved in your group or in your project work. Please do not, you know, this UK attitude, this UK, sorry, weather, it has a sort of way of making you feel reluctant, tired, you know, this summertime kind of thing. And so it kills vibe a lot. So please do not fall for the weather, this cold weather. Please do not fall for it. Make sure you keep your assignments up to date. Make sure you attend your group work, your project work, and all of that. So with all this, you'll be able to go back into this students, into this reading spirit. Another thing you could also try is to make sure that you are close to your project supervisor or your course supervisor or your department's head or something. Just get close to someone that can mentor you. Once in a while, we need motivation. We need people that are already there to tell us, oh, you can do it. Oh, you're on the right track. Oh, why don't you try it like this? Why don't you try it like that? So I think you should get used to these people. Go closer to them. Another step you could also try is to actually go online and just leave your books that they give you in school, that just go online and hear what other people are saying about that particular course. For instance, you're talking about chemistry and your lecturer has already given you a definition of chemistry. Yes, you could actually expatiate on that or research more on that. Let me use that word, research more on that, and try to go deeper into what chemistry is all about. So if somehow you're reading what your lecturer told you about chemistry and it's just not, you know, just not getting it, you should actually research more and get a term that is more okay for your understanding, a term, a definition that you can easily assimilate and understand, and then you go with it. So that's just basically all. Please, I'm wishing you a very, very fruitful semester, a fruitful year. Yes, and please, we know that we're all here to study. Don't go and start looking for money because you're already used to this money. Don't just go and look for money, 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 money. No, you're here primarily for study. So please, try and endeavor to study. Talk with your coursemates. Try reading techniques. There are a lot of reading techniques you could try. Yes, you could try any of that and you are good to go. So thank you for watching. I really do appreciate. Bye.